to go and get presented to court. So by the time you issue a warrant, there must be solid evidence that is sufficient that we are ready to go and obviously deal with the matter at hand. As far as actually approaching the SAPS on Monday, in fact, Mr. Morocco was also part of that delegation. We physically went to the SAPS to say, I read, like probably most of you, that I'm wanted. Nobody's looking for me. I'm here looking for you guys. And obviously we had conversations with them. In an event where we need to go to court as well, it's something we don't fear. It's something that doesn't give us sleepless nights. We will present, you know, our side of the story in court. And obviously, you know, as I said, I don't want to put out too much for now. What is important, though, is understanding that when it comes to journalism and media and social networks and what, it's opinion. And it's unfortunate that everybody has a view and everybody has something to say about something they have no idea of. You know, hence why I was making an example of my relationship with Mr. Morocco. Nobody even in this meeting knows our agreements and what we've signed, the two of us. But should our relationship break down, everybody will have something to say. Everybody will take sides. So we understand that as far as media is concerned, its perceptions, its opinions, its views, that hold absolutely no weight. When you stand in front of court, opinions means absolutely nothing. You know, headlines mean absolutely nothing. It is where you now need to present facts. You've got to back up what you say. And unfortunately, if you're not able to prove and verify what you've alleged, things can turn and go the other way very quickly, which is obviously something my legal team is working day and night to attend to, as well as obviously a number of steps and processes that were not followed in terms of the city press, because I think what they were focusing on is trying to break the story first. And obviously, when it comes to media, what matters is how much traffic we can drive. And obviously, who broke the story, that's the big thing. You know, there's a lot of points that were sent out by my legal team, which were, you know, it was completely ignored. Some of the responses that were given was taken out of context. It was a complete mess. But we obviously understand, you know, somebody actually asked me a question, which I think was a very valid question. What was the objective? And I think, as leaders, and I believe a lot of us who are on this meeting are IBs, you got to sit down sometimes and ask yourself, what is the objective? You've written a story based on opinions. He said, she said, okay, fair enough. And then what must happen? Now that the story is out, what must happen? What is the intention? What is the objective? Because honestly, if you have a dispute against somebody, I believe we've got the police station, we've got courts, we've got the NPA, you know, there are platforms to ventilate such matters, and there are platforms that are provided, you know, by the state to deal with any disputes, whether it's a civil case, whether it's a criminal case, whether it's a fraud case. There are different types of courts, you know, high court, constitutional courts, that were designed, you know, for disputes between partners, between spouses, between family members, between employer, employee, CCMA. So there are such platforms, but you ought to understand and ask yourself, honestly speaking, if you have an honest and genuine case, why do you want to involve the media? Why don't you focus on taking this individual to court, present the facts in court, and get this person behind bars? If you really have a case that you believe, you know, it's honest, it's genuine, there's merit to this case, I believe that should be the process, and that's how it should be followed. But once you start, you know, going the route that I believe has been taken, we're not new to these things. And I think if you go back and look at the history of my journey, allegations and these things is something that is not new, especially with some of these media houses. I've never been a friend of News 24. There's still articles hanging from 2015 saying this and that, which is part and parcel of I believe the nature of our relationship. I don't entertain such things. I don't give it the airtime that they're looking for, minus to focus on the job at hand and do what I need to do. And hence why I said to Mr. Morocca, I'm not in the business of responding to allegations, but I will respond to our IBs because these people are part of our family. If they've got concerns, they've got questions, I'm more than happy to ensure that I respond to and obviously get them to understand where we are at the moment and obviously what exactly is I think somebody's in the waiting room and what exactly is obviously going on. But from here, ladies and gents, I think ours is to obviously follow the necessary process. And obviously, I think as things unfold, one will be probably updating. I might request Mr. Morocca to give those updates. And I think I'd like to just leave it there. I'm sure some of us really want those finer details, but as I alluded, because we're at the stage that we're at, and I think at this particular point, whether there's, you know, any retraction, we really don't care. Whether there's apologies being sent out, we really don't care. I think now that we've begun this process, we might as well go all the way. And I think that's basically our stance. And I hope it makes sense when I say ours, because I'm sure, you know, a lot of people are saying to me, Sandy, why are you not saying anything? Why are you not saying anything? Why are you not coming out? As I said, our phones are ringing day and night. We've even requested that everything gets redirected to the attorney's office. We are not going to entertain the media. We want to find or get our day in court and obviously deal, because if it is a legal process, let's follow the process and finish. And I think at the end of the process, I might, because once we've completed that process, then I think there might be a possible need to come back and actually present the facts, because by then the legal process is completely done. I'm going to request to leave it there. I think we've gone literally 10 minutes into it. I requested that we end at 7 o'clock. Can I just quickly hand it over to you, Ms. Morocca?